الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, when the academic school finished, brothers and sisters came to the masjid and they asked me, so Brother Ibrahim, what is the summer school going to be for the kids? And I said, it's not summer school, it's a summer camp, inshallah. And then they ask, how many weeks? I say, 6 weeks. I say, how many juz of the Quran they can memorize? And I reply, I say, it's only 18 ayah. I say, what are you talking about? It's only 18 ayah. We need one juz or two juz. This is summer. I said, believe it or not, it's only 18 ayah from the Quran in this 6 weeks, inshallah, they're going to learn. Nothing else. What surah? I say, Surah Al-Hujurat. And I call the whole summer camp strong home, strong nation, under the shade of Surah Al-Hujurat. That's it. And every week, now we have, alhamdulillah, 4 weeks so far, we take one of the characteristics, good characteristics, through Surah Al-Hujurat, and we practice it. And the purpose of that, brothers and sisters, that I see, as my dear brother Safa said it clearly, said the school, the most important things in America is Islamic schools. Because in the public school, who teaching our kids in the school? Al-Maghdub alayhim and al-Dalim, nothing else. And I want my kids to be learned Surat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim. Very simple. So my dear brothers and sisters, when we want to build our community brick by brick, then honestly, if you look at Surat al-Hujurat and spread Surat al-Hujurat and look at it, each single ayah from the beginning to the end, ayah number 1 to now ayah number 18, you'll be very surprised. Is a foundation of family, foundation of ummah, in fact, foundation of a strong ummah. And that was the Sahaba radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim. Let me ask you a question, brothers and sisters. Do you know how many muhajir from Mecca to Medina migrate? Less than 150 muhajir only. 150 muhajir less. And guess what? We are now, by the CIA survey, we are 1.9 billion Muslims in the world. Allahu Akbar! 1.9 billion Muslims, and look at our features. If you look next to each other, completely we are different features, different nationalities, different the Ummah, different languages. It's not a condition for the Ummah to speak only Arabic. No, it's not. But all this Ummah, there is a core and a center for the Ummah. What is that center? What is that core? It's the Quran. Simple. All the Ummah came around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for one purpose. For what that? La ilaha illallah. Nothing else but that. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, المجتمع الإسلامي, the Muslim society is so unique. So beautiful, and the foundation of the Muslim society is the Quran. Very simple. We know that. Not only that, the tariqh, the history, they spoke about it clearly. Even non-Muslims, when they speak about the Muslim Ummah, when they migrate from Mecca to Medina, as my brother Safa said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akha bayna al-muhajirin wa al-ansar, make a brotherhood between al-muhajirin and ansar. And from there, they start to become powerful. In fact, in Medina itself, a war for more than 500 years war between the two tribes, Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj. And this war, by La ilaha illallah, is gone. It's gone completely, and they become more stronger nation ever you can even imagine. My dear brothers and sisters, this Muslim society, they have a manners and etiquette with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no exceptions. Regardless is the language or the features. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Arafat, in the first and last hajj for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brought everybody together and he said clearly, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ وَاحِدٌ. All people, your Lord is one Lord. وَإِنَّ أَبَاكُمْ وَاحِدٌ. Your father is one father. كلكم لآدم وآدم خلق من تراب. All of you belong to Adam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam from sand. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا فرق بين عربي على أعجمي. There is no difference between Arab over non-Arab, or superiority for Arab over non-Arab. أو أبيض على أسود, or white man over a black man. And he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who have a taqwa, God fearing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the difference between me, you, her, and them. Everybody have to understand the purpose of our creation to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to use all those bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. My dear brothers and dear sisters, Quran tahara qulub al-Muslimin. The Quran purify the hearts of the Muslims by Surah Al-Hujurat. Under the shade of Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah Al-Hujurat clean the heart, the envy, the animosity, the adawa between the people. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered those people to follow those ayats. Simple, my dear brothers and sisters. And that's why the Muslim society, they lived individual and jama'at and with the groups with love, sincerity, loyalty, ta'at of passion and compassion between among them. All of them just like one body, the whole ummah. The whole nation, just like one nation, if one of the part of the body in pain, the whole body will be in pain. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, sometimes we feel very sad when we see, look at the Muslim world. Anywhere you look, Muslims getting killed every place. And this was the worst of the worst. When you find Muslims and Muslims, they are fighting and killing each other. I'm not negative, astaghfirullah al-azim. I'm very positive. But that is with what we see. That's what we observe. As my dear brother Muhammad Siddiqui mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah azza wa jal wants you to work, to be united. Because if you are united, you will never be defeated. Simple. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, the Mujtama' al-Islami, the Muslim society, they have etiquettes and manners with themselves and with the enemy also. Even in the matter of war. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the battle of Badr giving orders to the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, don't kill an old man or an old woman or a child, or do not even take a uprooted tree. No. There's rules and regulations. Look what happened to the Muslim Ummah now. And they fight for the sake of peace, they kill Muslims. But honestly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not going to change a nation until the nation they change themselves first. We have to change. Few months, now 2 months, in September Ramadan is coming up. From now you see the emails start. People have a knowledge about Islam or no knowledge about Islam, they start to chat and send massive emails about moon sighting. Leave this issue for the people, they understand the issue. And why? Because that will cause, my dear brothers and sisters, last Ramadan, astaghfirullah, Eid al-Adha, 3 Eids we have. Not one, not two, 3. Why? In the same household, people have 3 Eids. That is the problem. But we must fix the problem to be united. We must think seriously from this moment. You listen to the 3-4 lectures today. If you just leave, oh mashallah, they did good job. This is not enough. It is absolutely not enough. If you don't go out and you practice what you heard, is this one, this time will be worthless. It's nothing. We must practice. That's what we are missing. We attend many conferences. Many conferences. Lectures here and there, and everyone is speaking about the same issue. What is the problem in the Muslim Ummah? Unity. They will be united. When the Sahaba radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim, they take the order from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they apply this order themselves on their own selves, and then they spread it and they practice it among themselves and others. It's not only just listen and good job. No, my dear brothers and sisters. The Islam is a practical. What is Iman? Iman, you qawl fil lisan, a statement, you say it by your tongue. But in the same time, you have to believe it in the heart. And you have to practice it. This is the key. practicing the word that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger commanded you to do. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, in Surah Al-Hujurat, in fact, is a foundation for the Muslim Ummah. I'm not going to go because of the time through it, but I advise myself and I advise you, go and study and listen about for Surah Al-Hujurat. Surah Al-Hujurat. 18 ayah is not a big deal. But wallahi, my inshallah hope, with those I have 60 kids in the summer camp, my plan for those 60 kids, every one of them become a leader. In fact, those kids right now, this coming week, they are writing letters to the senators, Congress, people in charge in the country to stop the war. Maybe they are kids, but believe it or not, they make their own survey. Their own survey, what they have to do to stop what's going on to the Muslim Ummah right now. They're doing this right now, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. And they are kids. We just give guideline to them in the blackboard. This is the guideline. And they go and they know, they make it their job. My dear brothers and sisters, don't say, oh, this job for people only who know about Islam, graduating from the Muslim community or the Muslim universities. No, it is not. Let me ask you a question. Who is better? You or the bird? Who? Who's better? We. Why? Because Allah says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, you are best than any nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. That bird, call it Hudhud. The Hudhud in the time of Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam. That bird flew all the way to Yemen. And he saw people worshipping the sun. And he came back to Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam what? Angry. He was very angry. And I saw, and he told the Prophet Sulaiman, I saw something, and I have knowledge, something you don't know. What do you know? I don't know. I'm a prophet. And he said, I saw people worshipping the sun. And they should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at that. They must worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, if that bird find his own way to spread the da'wah, to do his job, don't you can't find your way or not? And you are better than the bird, believe me, brothers and sisters. Especially you as a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. كُنْتُمْ, you are the best of the nation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised for mankind. Do you know why? تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. Enjoining what is right. Enjoining what is right, forbidding what is wrong, and to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know it's not easy, especially now, but I know you can do it. Start, and you'll see the difference in the Muslim community. You will, this village you're talking about, brother, you will build this village. And what is the big deal? This village to be United States of America. For us. Why? Brothers and sisters, 2 weeks ago I was invited from one of the judges in Austin, and the judge called me and he said, I Google you and and I found out you have an Islamic degree. Can you come to the court and be witness? I said, why? And he said, there is a couple, they have fighting Muslims, and I don't know any idea, I have no idea about Islamic marriage and divorce. I went there and this man lift his podium and he came and shake hand and have a chair and make me speak about what is marriage and divorce. And then this man, he said, can you take those couple and go to the room and speak with them? Maybe you solve this problem. I feel so shy, wallahi al-azim. I feel so shy. Wallahi, I become very cold, my body very cold, when I hear that man telling me, go and solve their problem. Honestly, I was very rude. When I talk to them inside, I say, fear Allah, both of you. Fear Allah. You have no fear. More than $20,000 for each attorney. Total around $50,000. For what? Because of arrogant? Pride? Why have extra money? What are you talking about? والله I told him I was very angry because I told you have no shyness, no modesty, no haya. If you slick this man telling me go and solve their problem. Alhamdulillah, maybe this rudeness make them actually wake up. But my dear brothers and sisters, we must wake up. And this is the time. We have here around 100 brothers and sisters. I believe you are almost just like the number of the Sahaba in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Muhajirin. Is that right? I think today before you leave this place, if you have a mission, target in your community, in your life, in your job, with your family, with your own family, and go home and don't wait for tomorrow. No, tonight apply it. Tonight! Now have the intention, at least, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. My dear brothers and sisters, Al-Quran, I really don't have time. But when we have a dispute among the Muslim community, and very soon you will find this dispute coming up because of Ramadan, unfortunately. We're supposed to be happy, but we start to argue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said clear the dalil, the proof, the solution in the Quran. فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ. If any dispute, any problem, any matters. فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. Take it to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِن كُنتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. If you believe in Allah and the hereafter. If Allah telling you that, don't say my way or the highway. Say the way of Allah and His Messenger, I will follow their steps, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he in the khutbah Arafat, and I will summarize it. More than 120,000 people there. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking the people. And he said, what is today? The day of Yawm al-Nahr, Yawm al-Eid, the day of the Eid. What is today? And the Sahaba replied, the Sahaba, they know it's the day of the Eid. And they said, Allah wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger knows best. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alaysa Yawm al-Nahr? Today is the Yawm of the slaughtering, Yawm al-Adha. And they says, Bala, yes indeed. And say, Ayy shahrun hada? What month? Everybody knows this, Dhul Hijjah. But they thought, the Prophet is going to change it. Respect and manners and etiquettes with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the month? And they says, oh, Allah and His Messenger knows best. 120,000 people, they cannot say, oh, today, this month is the month of Dhul Hijjah. This is Allah and His Messenger knows best. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, alaysa dhul hijjah? Today is dhul hijjah. Say, yes, it is dhul hijjah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start, what is country, what city? My dear brothers and sisters, that is the way of the Prophet and the Sahaba, the etiquette. You must have this kind of etiquette when you hear hadith and ayah to build the community, to make the community strong. Time is over. But the most important thing, my dear brother Muzammal Saddiqi mentioned it fast, and I will mention it fast also. My dear brothers and sisters, the most important, look at Surah Al-Hujurat and those orders in commands. The most important orders, I want you just to listen because the time is over. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةَ. All the brothers, all the believers, they are brothers and sisters. لا إيمان بدون أخوة. There is no إيمان without brotherhood, and there is no brotherhood without إيمان. Simple. If you want to be a believer, you want to be a Muslim, have a relationship with your brother, sister with sister, a kind of relationship, regardless color, regardless nationality, be an ummah. Just like Ibrahim alayhi salam, by himself he was an ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to the right path. Ameen. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.